And what the hell is happening here? Oh no. Oh my god! What? I mean, I heard that he turned on him and I thought they were going to be able to work it out for this, though. This does not look like working it out whatsoever. This looks like a beatdown event. Oh no. God, he turned on him in VWA. I guess it's official now. There. And ladies and gentlemen, after that, I guess, shocking betrayal, I just heard from the general manager that the tag team titles were vacated by Andre Brooks and they will be decided. The tag team championships will be decided in, I guess, a four-team match?
From New Orleans, Louisiana, weighing in at 225 pounds, Chase Matthews!
And now you have Chase Matthews making his entrance to the ring against William Nova tonight. And this all started because after they lost that tag team matchup, Chase Matthews put hands on, I mean, William was trying to tell him what, oh. I mean, he was trying to tell him, damn, what was going on, but he wasn't hearing it. So, you know, oh, wait a minute. William Nova just getting his revenge right now on Chase. Him and Chase. I mean, they were tag team partners. Chase then choked the shit out of him. Oh, God. And now William is attacking him from behind. That seems like more of a Chase deal. I mean, are they even going to make it to the ring? Oh, my God. I don't think they give a damn about the ring right now. And I'm waiting to see if the GM is going to call this matchup. Oh! Oh, my God. And what is he going for? He going to do it again? Oh, he split him out. That hurts. That hurts. Oh, went to grab him. Wasn't nothing there. Ooh. Grabs. And now he is trying. He's got him in that sleeper hold that he put him in. Well, he didn't get it all the way in because he was probably looking for what he did out there in the parking lot. And now William Nova throwing him down towards the ring. And this is a rivalry that will probably keep going. The referee has learned that he is calling the match. The GM will deal with this next week. And now the saga of PK King and Ken Washington continues as returning to the ring for the first time. And oh my God, I don't know how long. Aaron Abbott, a man who retired from the ring to do personal security for Ken Washington, back in the ring, at least in an NHW ring, for the first time in about 3 years. That is insane, but it's true. This seven-footer is a legit seven-footer, former tag team champion, never held singles gold, but his opponent tonight is somebody that I'm not allowed to talk about, especially with the boss out here. And that is a man who gets no music, no introduction. He's just a person that wrestles here at this moment. And I feel like I know what's going on here. I don't know what the deal is with, oh my God, I re-downloaded fucking A, 2K.
And his opponent, from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 224 pounds, PK King!
2K, bruh, I need y'all to work on some things with the community creations, right? And how when you download calls, right, you fix like things like, I don't know, the fucking tattoo. Like, a lot of people, I hope somebody actually watches this and cares enough. But a lot of people put a lot of time and effort into these calls, these creations that, you know, whether they're using them for, like, e-feds or whether they're just using them for themselves and want to upload a version of themselves for somebody. Like, this is what you do. You fuck it up every time. Like, goddamn, this has been years of this. Holy shit. It can't get worse. You can't make it. Like, and I understand. Fuck it, I'm a rant. Like, I understand. The game, in its essence, looks great. Sure, it does. But good God, the amount of bullcrap that, yeah, I censored myself. Damn, I'm proud of me. The amount of bullcrap that we have to go through in order for, do you know why my call is, yeah, everybody knows. Fuck it. My call is the little one down there. Little one, he's 6'4", 254, anyway, but Micah, actually, yeah, let's talk about that, because Aaron Abbott's shirt was fucked up, because there's supposed to be an Ego Powers logo on it. Ain't no Ego Powers logo on it, but you know why Micah down there is good and basic? I have three whole textures on him, three. Would you like to know why, anybody? Okay, because if you put more then like a certain amount of textures on your car, for whatever reason, when you upload him, it looks correct in the download. I have this problem with Trevor Hannibal. I have re-downloaded him, and for whatever reason, his freaking face texture is still on the side of his goddamn head. Like, fix your shit, 2K. It's crazy that people put the amount of time, and some people pay for their calls. Like, I would be pissed if I paid for a call, I download it. Like, they show me the preview, and it looks great. I download it, and everything's in disarray. Oh, my God. Okay. I think I'm done ranting. I think. I'm not sure. I'm gonna just leave it alone and try to call this match. 2K. And this is a shout out to the homie Monica Monroe. I really don't like your game. Like, me and her have had the funniest of conversations about how tag team matches work. No, I guess I'm not done ranting. About how tag team matches work. About how some of the singles matches work. You know, I have people send me all the time, and yes, Devin, I'm talking to you in particular. They send me shit to change sliders, and I sometimes do try it, even though I always tell Devin no, because I don't want him to know that I do try them sometimes, and they don't work out the way they're supposed to, and then I'm left standing here, sitting here, actually, confused on what the hell this game actually is. Like, how is it that broken at its fundamental core that this stage in itself is it took me, I don't know, four tries to do it, and it actually reset my other profile, which why I'm glad I have two profiles, one to create stuff and one to actually use for the shows, because when that one reset itself at random after making this arena, yo, I really almost like asked for a refund on the game and been like, all right, I'm not doing NHW. But I do love the people that have been dealing with me for years and have rocked with me through all of the BS that I've went through. I've made some great friends in this. I've tried to keep my head down, mind my damn business. But oh my God, 2K, you gotta fix this. Yeah, I know you ain't gonna, but I just needed to rant for a minute. Because me and the owner of the PK call, me and the owner of the PK call, we're literally talking about this crap. And now we see it. I see it again after re-downloading it. it's still FUBARed. That's also why I don't change my call a lot either, because if it uploaded and worked the first time, that's just how it's going to be. Anyway, now I'm going to try to call this match. Got a two count there from Aaron Abbott. Aaron Abbott trying to get back on the, trying to get on a roll at all. This is his first match in NHW in 3 years. PK King and MC Adams not liking, and I don't think him and Aaron have a history. But I know that him and Ken do. And now he's going for the pin on the big man after drop kicking him in the back of his head. Only gets a two count. That's close to 400 pounds you're trying to move around, PK. And, okay. Damn! Don't pose. That shit don't work out for you. Get you punched in the mouth. I think that Ken is trying to prove a point right here. MC telling him to calm down. PK still fighting for his life at the moment, it feels like. And now gonna throw him off the ropes. And caught him with that cutter, but does he have enough to roll over and throw his arm? There you go. Just throw your arm over there. He might be through. That might be the end of Aaron Abbott, which would really piss off his best friend, boss man, whatever you want to call him. Here we go. I don't know how this is gonna work as far as like a hockey fight. If they bust it down to that, I know Aaron's slower than PK. Like, I've never seen it with someone as the tall person versus the short person. It looks like, again, the game has not been kind to tall calls for ever since like 2K19. Like, they were I'm back to bitching again. Let me stop. Okay. Throws him into the corner. Oh, nice kick over. Okay. Combination platter I don't know if I'm allowed to say his name. The ref is, or the boss isn't looking. PK King. And now puts him on the ropes, getting ready to send him again. And another cutter right there. Has him in the middle of the ring. Hooks that leg. 1, 2, 3. And you know that Ken is pissed. He's still not allowed to play his music. But you see how Ken is looking at him. I feel like these two are going to have to meet again. I mean, it was a count out victory the last time. Ken said that he wasn't trying to fight him. They both been talking a lot of shit all over the call world. Let's really see what they... And now...
The following contest is a 2 out of 3 falls match and is for...
I mean, I don't even know what to say right now. It just, everybody getting the business today. You know what I'm saying? William Nova and Chase Matthews just tried to beat the shit out of each other. Match didn't even get to start. Andre turned on Kyle. Ran his head, all through everything. That was fun to watch, I guess. It probably wasn't fun for Kyle so much. But now we have another man getting another opportunity to bring Rustin Moseley down a peg. Rustin has been holding on to this honor chair, and he's not even having rivalries. You understand what I'm saying? He's just been out here putting hands on people, and now he gets his opportunity to put hands on Carnage. Carnage getting his opportunity at the NHW Honor Championship and this Honor Championship rules match. As stated before, this is a 2 out of 3 falls match. No submissions, pins only. You get a 5 count on the outside of the ring, and hopefully that'll make you stay in the ring. And you got a 20-minute time limit. So if it comes to time, then Rustin is, of course, going to remain the champion. Rustin has been defending that championship all over the place. I really don't know if anybody can stop him. Like, if the Honor Championship kind of took the place of the TV title, I'm pretty sure if he went and told the GM, yo, I'm trying to move divisions, which is getting kind of crowded, because, oh boy, former champion is fighting the current champion tonight. We know that Anthony Martin still gets his rematch. Not rematch, damn, he never had it to lose it. Still gets his match for the world's championship. I really don't know what to do with all the information I'm trying to spew. You understand? I do hope you guys enjoyed Capital Pro Wrestling last night. The first episode, it crowned some Capital Pro champions, as their specific champions were not able to be back in time this season because we had other things we had to do. But they're always welcome. They know who they are. I think they still watch this, even though they're not a part of anymore. They're always welcome. You know what I'm saying? Because I think somebody just, like, sneezed and called Rustin pathetic. The real deal, Rustin Moseley, as I said, I'm going to go back to it. Yeah, but he has been holding on to that championship for a minute. And every time he defends it, he has to step out and be escorted out by security. I mean, the last match that he had against, or his last opponent, Eddie J. Yeah, you know, as soon as the match was over, because he did it in a devious way. Let's call a spade a spade. He did it in a devious way. He got the count out and then rolled him down for the pin. Oh, that sounded crazy. Oh, woo, boy. That was a wild-ass statement I just made. Good golly. All right. We're going to shut up now. We're going to let the ref do his, or not the ref, but the guy do his thing for that right there. And I will be honest. Shows that have big meaning to them will have commentary on them.
The challenger from London, England, weighing in at 275 pounds, the General Cornick. And his opponent from Little Rock, Arkansas, weighing in at 255 pounds, the Honor Champion, Rustin
Moseley, holding that championship. And what I was going to say was, you know, workload's getting a little high. I do want to complete the six seasons. Oh my God, I got to stop smoking. I'm not going to do that. I made a funny. But yeah, no. What the fuck was I saying? Oh yeah, some will be commentated, some will not. That's how I know the next 2 weeks will not be commentated. There's a lot going on, and for recording times, I won't have time to then put a voiceover to them. I used to do it live as the matches were going, but that was taking so much time. I found it easier to record and then put my voice to it. But I don't, that's not going to be sustainable for some matches. And I've all but given up on the music, I guess. Oh my God. But wee! Full Nelson suplex there. Man hits him with a German to follow. And ooh, Rustin with the good little break there. Oh my God, put the boot to him. We haven't seen Carnage in a couple of weeks. But the ring hit Al with the bitchinest mullet on this planet. Hey, you gotta give the people what they want. And if you don't want a bitchin' mullet, then I don't know who you are. I don't understand you. Because everybody wants a mug. Rustin is kicking the shit out of him right now. Hey. So if you think about the honor rules, it's kind of like the what's the peer championship. There you go. There's specific rules that go with it. Boy, there was no one. He duck and dodged you. That DDT on that mullet had to hurt. Them spikes probably went into his arm. He probably damaged too. And look at him. This is how he won last time. Oh, wait. The referee backed him up, probably saving Carnage from the count out. Because Rustin was going to go back out there and put more hands on him. Oh, whoa, wait a minute. Hold on. Damn. Almost threw Rustin out of the ring there. Oh. Plus, I'm trying to get some shows out the way because I got, be honest with you, I'm going to a TNA event this weekend. Next weekend. Yeah, it's next weekend. I'm trying to have some of these shows out the way because, man, the holidays are coming up. That's the other reason I can't really do a lot of commentary, because the holidays are coming up. The kids are out of school, and for whatever reason, when my kids hear that I'm recording something, they think they need to put their voice in there, so I just kind of record in silence. Hopefully you guys can make some stories going as you will, except for Chase and William. Oh, I have an idea. So I could take screenshots. I've seen Wide Prime Wrestling do that. I could take screenshots and kind of build the stories on the X machine. Even though I hate it, I will put a poll up on the National Honor Wrestling Twitter page to see if we're moving to Blue Sky or if we're going completely Discord. I'm about had it with X. I get, man, the amount of bullshit I have to put up with for them. But anyway, yeah, that's what I'll. Oh my god, dropped him down and Rustin back to his feet. But Carnage putting the shoe to him. Are we about to have a big man flying? Yeah, he spent a little bit too much time up there. Uh-oh, never mind. That elbow is good. Here we go. Nice clotheslines there. And Carnage, that face was one of one. Oh, hell, here he goes. Rustin's getting in that spot. He's getting in that place. Knee, short arm, clothesline. Picks him up. Yeah, he's got to remember that Carnage got some shit in the bag. Boy, he jumped over him twice. Oh, tried for the back elbow. Carnage has him and deposits him over the top rope and stands right on the logo. Ref at the count of one. This would make sense. I mean, hello? That's going to be a count out. Well, that's one for Carnage. And Carnage fell for the trap. It looks like he fell for the trap. Now, what happens if you get a double count out? Well, I don't know. If Rustin gets counted out again, it's a count out victory. So, Carnage would not get the championship. Rustin, you dirty dog. And look at him. Oh no, he going to the top rope. I thought he was about to go grab his championship and take a stroll. I never thought about that though. If he gets, woo boy, he would loaded that one up. Ripcord into the lariat, into the pin. The ropes are right there. He could grab it too. Only a two count. Tomorrow's show is not, yeah. It's, I think I already said that. I got some smoking. I swear. No, I'm not going to stop. I don't know why. I keep lying to myself. Boy, he was getting ready to fuck you up. Anyway, Ooh. But yeah, tomorrow's show will not have commentary because of when I recorded it. And I've been going to a lot of wrestling shows lately. I actually got front row tickets to the TNA show. And you'll probably see, if you know what I look like, you'll see me in the front row just kind of cutting a fool, especially when Joe Hendry comes out. You got to believe. Oh, now they about to have themselves a go. Oh, we went to slap him. He said, no, sir. Oh, they having hands now. Remember, Rustin is still down a fall, technically. Boy, that's the glitchiest shit I've ever seen. Damn. What the? Oh, my God. Yeah. Back and forth. Is this going to lead to a hockey fight? You see the crowd is standing. They are prepared for this. They believe in the fight. There's the hockey fight. Oh, they just going at it right in the center of the ring. You love to see that. Both of them dazed and confused, but neither fell. Carnage took the advantage for a moment, then caught that hip toss. Here comes Rustin stalking his prey. Oh, God. Oh, yep. Hey, that move looked familiar. Like, he kind of stole it. Whatever. One, two. Only a two count. Rustin has used that move to put away so many people. Looks like he's getting ready to load him up again. Oh, flipped him out. Pause. Blockbuster style. Two. Only a two count still. Rustin has no idea what to do right now. I don't think Rustin has been in this much danger since he fought Eddie J. Do you know why? Because Eddie J was up on him for a clip. And now Carnage busted open. And if they both get counted out, that means that Carnage will win. He just fired him up. Oh, y'all just don't care, huh? Y'all just fighting it out. Yeah. Yeah, y'all just doing the Lord's work, huh? I don't know what happens here. Huh? Does that count as a fall for Rustin? I really need to figure that out. That should be a rope break. Oh, yeah. But you can't win by submission. Go for the pin. Pin him, Rustin. Rustin. I'm gonna have to talk to Rustin. Oh, never mind. He got that elbow off into the pin. One, two, three. And there was one fall. Okay, so the double count out can't happen? What the hell? Okay. Alright. Nope. I'm fucking confused. So confused. That knee drop is not confusing, though. Ooh. Beautiful frog splash. Carnage hasn't even been able to get up off the ground. He might be out. And there's another defense for Rustin. I don't even know what to say at this point. But I'm sure that Carnage is going to have something to say. Rustin is going to find himself in a position that he's not going to like. His next defense will probably be against Devin Harrell for that Honor Championship. If what I'm hearing is correct, Devin Harrell came to an agreement with the Boss Man. And I don't know if Franco knows about it. Uh-oh. And saying that Carnage is slowly staggering back to his feet. You see him getting out the ring. There he goes again. That's the second time.
Ah. Yo, this is your boy, the Suplex Assassin, Alex Kane, former MLW World Heavyweight Champion. And I need y'all to check out my guys at Guerrilla Warfare Wrestling. Every day. Stream it every day. Enjoy it every day. Pick your favorite characters. And just have the best time you possibly can, because you know I will. I am. I love it. Check it out on the Eminence Network. And that is on Boomaye! Boomaye! Boomaye!
Get it spilled in that race, so fight me. The competition feels the beast inside me, and I plan to take you out. See, fight me. It's going down. But the moment that bell rings, your fear is so enticing. Fight me. I don't care about the dates that find me, cause I ain't afraid of nothing. Fight me.
All right, let's see if I can stay on track this match. Because I lost it last match. I really did. Anyway, now coming to the ring. Oh, wait.
Is a special guest referee match.
Wait, what the fuck?
Welcome the special guest referee for this match, Anthony Martin.
Wow, Anthony Martin. Oh, that's kind of dirty pool, because we know that Marcus Smith is owed a rematch for the World's Heavyweight Championship, the NHW World's Heavyweight Championship. Omari is the current champion, and Anthony Martin is technically the number one contender for the Men's World Championship. I mean, him and Jackson had some beefs, you know what I'm saying? Jackson actually will be main eventing the next Capital Pro show, defending that Capital Pro championship that he has been holding on to for the last couple of months. And we'll see how that goes. But right now, Anthony Martin in the ring as the special guest referee. That is crazy. NHW special referee for this matchup. How cool is that? Well, I was about to go off the rails again. It's in my head. I'm just trying not to say it. You know what I'm saying? Oh, my God. Oh, my Lord. Anyway, now coming to the ring for this main event matchup. First, the champ coming out first. Omari Aranoa coming to the ring. Been holding on to that NHW Men's World Champion, World Heavyweight Championship for a while now. And, I mean, he's got some contenders. Jackson gave him about all that he could handle. So who knows what will happen if, you know what I'm saying, when inevitably he has to face Anthony Martin. And then, you know, you also have Marcus Smith in the Wheats. And we know that his family is, listen, Jason is a little crazed person, right? And he's going to be fighting in the next Capital Pro show in one of the matches. So we'll see how that goes. But right now, what we have going on is the Gods of Samoa coming to the ring, ready to go, ready to get this underway. And Lord have mercy, I am not ready, I do not think. And there comes Marcus with his dad and Jason's dad, but I don't see Jason. This is fucked up. This entrance is fucked up. Because Marcus is supposed to be in the middle. Wait, hold on. No, that's... Wait, hold on. Okay. Yeah, I guess we'll see when it comes to the match. Because ain't that Jason?
And his opponent, from Honolulu, Hawaii, weighing in at 250 pounds, Marcus Smith.
I am very confused at this particular moment. No, that is Marcus. I'm drunk. So, Marcus is supposed to be in the middle, flanked by his father and Jason's father. And then there's... Where the hell is Jason? Because all... I'm not redoing it. I love y'all, but I'm not redoing it. This is absolute insanity. I'm fucking tired. I hate it. I fucking hate it. I'm not... It changed the whole damn entrance. It's not the right bloodline entrance. Oh, I fucking hate this game. Lord Jesus Almighty, I hate this game. Oh God, it's not the right entrance. Oh well, at least Marcus is coming to the ring. Maybe if I put the Ulfalo on him, you know, it'll make him come out in the way he's supposed to. Oh, fuck! Okay, I'm trying not to spaz. Y'all entrance long as fuck, though. Okay. Cool. Wow. You could at least made it the right entrance game. Like, what title is he holding? Hello, game. Help me understand. What is he holding right there? Marcus Smith as the wise man when he's supposed to be the man. I don't know what to say. I bet you he's gonna get out the ring too, ain't he? He gonna get out the ring and let I think that's his dad stand there. Even though his dad is then gonna have to get out the ring so he can get back in it in order to have this match. And Jason is just gonna appear out of the blue fucking sky. Oh no, he didn't. Jason didn't even come to the ring with him, even though he was supposed to. Outstanding. And, oh, okay. Perfect pin count there, I guess. I have no hands on this. My job is just to keep the power on. And that, oh, God. Samoan spikes to the throat. Omari actually, is Omari the one that took the title from Marcus? I think he is. And no wonder there's a lot of bad blood in this. Listen, there's a lot that has happened, and I've smoked a lot of trees since then. Okay? Oh, my God. And Marcus just... oh, if Marcus can beat Omari, will he ask for a champion? Will he go ahead and ask for his rematch? That's number one. Number two, I mean, as these two Samoans just kind of beat the shit out of each other. Number two, Mr. Martin there. I mean, he's getting a first-hand view on how violent these two are. And Marcus, oh, there is no Surveyor, is there? Marcus Surveyor, which is not supposed to be Marcus Smith. Marcus Surveyor. Okay. I see you. But Anthony Martin, it looks like he's doing more of just reconning the situation. I mean, because these two actually used to be in a team together. When I'm talking about Marcus and Omari. Ow. The one with the dreads looks like he wants to say, I love you, Marcus. Oh, God. I hate this game so much. Oh, okay. And then, my bad. I ain't mean to make you tear off the turnbuckle. Big old power bomb. No sold the shit out of it. So he gave him a clothesline for his problems. There's a second one. Duck under. And a big lariat for the third one. Slides into this, the pin. Turnbuckle is exposed. That's a thing? Oh, that makes your meter go down.
Oh, wow. I did not know that.
I know that spear had to hurt. I don't know why I'm watching it. Like, that is interesting to me. Can he put it back? Oh, damn. Hey, go put the turnbuckle back for you get ejected as the referee. There you go. Oh. He was about to put it back. He was about to put it back. Crowd chanting fight forever as these guys are doing their business, and now he's putting a turnbuckle back on as Marcus Smith. Oh, God! And, oh, look at this. Got him goozled! He about to take the bitch right back off. He said, sir, I said leave the turnbuckle alone. There is a lot going on in this matchup that is not in favor of Anthony or Omari, to be honest. Anthony's actually been calling it down the middle, even though he will be facing Omari. Hell, probably before the pay-per-view. He called a good rope break. Good rope break call, not a great one. He gave him a second there. He let him handle some business. And now, oh, pop up into, what the fuck is that? Alright, well, both men are down. Omari back to his feet first. Marcus putting up a fight. Oh, got out the way. Oh, went to kick. Nobody home for that punt. Grabs him up, takes him for a stroll all the way across the ring when they were two closer turnbuckles. Fix your shit, 2K. And now is about to catch that side out. No, that's not even a Saito. That was like a dump you on your forehead. I don't really know what to call it. I gotta look up the name of that suplex. Saito is more of a back suplex where you get dropped on the back of your fucking head. And now, ooh, that's dangerous territory for Omari. And at the count of one, not sure. Oh, being talked to by one of the fathers. And I guess he's, you know, his dad giving, is that his dad? I think that's his dad giving him the business. Very fair. Okay. Them hands wasn't fair. Them hands was rude. Oh, kick to the mid. Stomp. He ain't got no shoes on. He face washing you. Yo, you gotta get up and punch him in the mouth, cuz. You can't let that shit slide, fam. You can't let that slide, fam-o. We're now gonna throw him off the ropes. Almost hit Anthony. And now, ooh, short arm lariat. Marcus said, no sell R us. Uh-oh. Float over DDT off the reversal. And now Omari stalking his prey, waiting for him to get to his feet again. That power bomb has put away so many. Good rope break call. Omari did not like that at all. Throws him at the, woo boy, he almost got the referee again. Get out of the way, Mr. Martin. Okay, he's showing off his strength. I don't know if I would be doing, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Okay. Sir, there's a closer turnbuckle. That was closer ropes. Oh, and God bless him mighty. Just a good suplex right on his fucking head. Two count, and his father and uncle? I don't know how that family dynamic works. I just know that they were both, you know, like, he ain't going. Oh, God. Oh, duck under. Anthony got in the way of what was happening there. Gut wrench, power bomb, suplex, all of that happening right then and there. And he said, unhand me. Goozle. Got him, Goozle. The ref's right there. It's not a choke. And he called the match. Holy shit. Oh, okay. All right, that's the business we on. Omari just beat Marcus Smith again with the referee, and I've already been told that Jason didn't come out because he's in the back and he is fussing with the GM, and there will be a match between Anthony and it's been a fucked up show anyway. There'll be a match between Anthony and what's his name, Marcus Sevilla next week. Or no, not Marcus, Jason. So that's the match that Jason will be in. All right, well, tune in to Capital Pro Wrestling to see that match. It will be non-commentated, no music, because trying something new with that might be how we go on from there. Whatever. Congratulations to Omari. I'll see you guys tomorrow night. Well, the game will, and, you know, I'll be at TNA. Yeah, this is the week of TNA. Shit. So I'll be at the TNA event when it airs. I don't have time to put music over it because, you know, work sucks. Yeah, well, no, it doesn't suck. I